All right, everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I have here a chunk of aluminum, angle aluminum. It's about 3 nanolight seconds long, but of course I'm only going to be using a small piece of it because today I want to actually destroy it using a liquid metal. You might have seen mercury destroying aluminum or gallium destroying aluminum. What I've not seen is an alloy which is liquid at a higher temperature also doing it. And I think it should. As long as the metal can dissolve the aluminum, then it should catalytically destroy it, as mercury will. So I'm going to try this out with some field metal. This is an alloyed mixture of 32.5% bismuth, 16.5% tin, and 51% indium. Okay, so that should be our alloy constituents. I gotta find a spoon or something to melt it down in. It of course takes a much higher temperature to melt it down right now because all the metals are separate. And they don't actually lower each other's melting point until they're actually mixed. But as soon as they do start mixing, you can see they melt quite quickly. Come on. There it is. And we have a liquid. What I like about this alloy is it's all non-toxic materials. You know, bismuth, indium, and tin, none of those are very toxic. There it is. Another pretty bit of metal. See? Sticks to things. In fact, this could be used to make a mirror, I think. Yeah. That burn was there. Well, that's cooling. Let's cut off a piece of this aluminum. I really need to bolt down my vise. There is one problem with this metal. It takes forever to solidify. So I've got some water here which I've warmed to about 80 degrees centigrade. So now let's drop in the metal and see if it melts. It should. Oh. Yeah, it's melting. Well, good. As you can see, we've moved over to the hot plate, and right now I'm just kind of scratching the aluminum to get rid of that oxide coating. If you've ever tried to react aluminum with another metal, you'll know that it's not exactly trivial. Aluminum forms that oxide coating, which is rather difficult to get through. But that should help, but of course the coating forms almost immediately. Whoops, it just rolled right off there. Maybe I should drill a divot into it. Okay, it's very similar to working with mercury, just a little higher temperature. Notice I'm scratching at it underneath of the metal so the oxygen can't get to it. Okay, you can see there's a little bit of oxide forming already. I'm not sure if that's from the tin and indium or if it's from the aluminum. This is what it currently looks like. So this is just after putting the bit of metal on there and then stirring it around so it made good contact with the aluminum. And now I'm gonna check on it maybe every half an hour or so. Okay, 4 a.m. Have a look at this. Looks more or less the same, except there is a little bit of like a gray around it, so it is affecting the aluminum. At 4:30, can't really tell.
think the dark spot has increased in size. Okay. It has definitely altered the piece of aluminum. Let's see what happens if I try bending it. See if it's made it brittle yet. Okay, so the metal appears to be still quite strong. Let's tip it over a little bit. Let's see what it's done to the actual metal. It doesn't appear to have eaten a crater into it or anything. Okay, so a bit of time has elapsed. You can see the aluminum has changed substantially though. Now this was weird because most of this change happened after I turned the hot plate off. You see, at about 8 a.m. I had to leave, and I didn't want to leave the hot plate running, so I just turned it off, let everything cool, and when I came back to this. So the metal has obviously oxidized substantially, so the Fields metal has soaked through the aluminum and disrupted the oxide coating in this area, and then the air was able to attack it. So if we flip it over, you can see it hasn't gone through all the way, but it has gone to the edges here. There's a couple of spots. So it seems to soak through laterally more than vertically. But yeah, the aluminum is still quite strong. That makes sense because it hasn't destroyed or interacted with the majority of it. But this is proof that the Fields metal will attack aluminum. So let's turn the hot plate back on. Let's let it sit on here for a few more hours with the metal liquid and see if it soaks through even more. Okay, just after 5:30, so you can see that there is a little bit of a gray, you know, a different colored silvery gray outline around this dark gray mark. The aluminum isn't being oxidized substantially. It's not until I cool it off that it starts to really destroy it. So maybe doing a thermal cycle would be more effective. So let's actually turn the hot plate off. Let's let it cool down again and see if that works. Let's see. Let me kind of mark it where the outline of that area is and then where this currently is. But if anyone has any idea why it causes the aluminum to really fall apart when it's cooling off, please let me know. And here we are. It is just after 7, and it has indeed marched along with the destruction of the aluminum. I'm looking over on this edge here, that's kind of interesting. Let me zoom in on that. Yeah, look at that, it's like it's crawled off the edge there. That's pretty cool. And of course, it is now hard. So yeah, it does seem like thermal cycling, it really does have an effect. Look around on the back side here. Looks like these areas are a little bit larger than last time. A little bit on this corner here. It makes me think that maybe we finally weakened it. Well, certainly not like that. Well, let's heat it up and let the metal melt again. Let's give it another cycle. All right, it's almost 8. Here's the metal, it's all warmed back up. Let's see if I can break it in half. It's still a little bit hard to crack, but look at that. I just pulled it right apart. I probably couldn't have done it just with my fingers, especially since it's so hot, but that was definitely substantially weaker. I like how it like had a juicy center almost. So this grayscale on the aluminum is not superficial. Like it goes pretty deep into it. The metal just completely crumbles. So one last quick little experiment here. Let's put some of this into some warm water. Ah, it's reacting. Okay, so it's extra sensitive to moisture. That might explain some things. It's actually decomposing the aluminum into aluminum oxide and hydrogen gas. Let's put some soap in the water so we can capture those bubbles, and let's see if they can be ignited. Let's throw this other piece in there too. Now we got it going. Let's turn off the lights. Now let's hit this with a torch and see if we get some hydrogen burning. Ah! So that's a way to get hydrogen out of water. Fields metal plus aluminum. So hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.